Entendemos a palavra, a doação, a melhor espírito, um grande amém. My holy father, my beloved brother, welcome again in a new episode in our Coptic language chain. We stopped last time at letter number 16, which was letter of O. As we said before, the normal sequence of all languages, MNO, or LMN in our Coptic language is Lavlamene XCO. So we arrived to letter number 16, which was letter Omicron or Okuji. But firstly, I want to give also a lot of thanks to my master, Deacon Marcus Isaac, Deacon of the Church of St. Mary and St. Abraham, Brighton, United Kingdom, for his notes and his recommendation to add the sound of the word in English letter to be easily in reading. So we will continue together this episode, but first I want to speak with you about why Egyptian considered number 13 is ominous or is bad thing. As we knew last episode, Egyptian sound number 13 was may or this sound was drawn in hieroglyphic in photo of owl, as we see it. Owl is considered in Egypt an example for sadness or mourning, or we can consider it ominous thing. That's all. Even till now in Egypt, in mourning or severe sadness, people hear saying that in Upper Egypt called it Yibawum. Yibawum, it means doing the sound of owl. Yibawum. That's all. Let's start together in our 17 letter in our Coptic language. Our 17 letter in our Coptic language is P. As we see it, P. Again, P. And its sound is P. Is a constant P. When we take an example for it, we will take this example of Epnevma, Epnevma, again, Epnevma. When we say in the name of the Father, we say, Epnevma. Epnevma, it means spirit. Epnevma. Another example, we can take it and we see it every day in church. Pandokrator. Pandokrator, again, Pantokrator, as we see, Pantokrator. Pantokrator word, it means Almighty. The icon of Pantokrator is present always in the eastern side in sanctuary. We see it every day. When we go to letter number 18, it's Row. Look at it. Row. 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 Row seems to like to be P in English, but its sound is completely different from P in English and row in Coptic. In Coptic, its sound is R. R sound. R sound. Let's take some examples. First example, For us is rompi. Again, rompi. Rompi, which means year. In each rompi, we are saying to each other, no free rompi. It means a happy new year or happy year. Rompi. Another word like rompi, but little bit different from rompi, is romi. Again, romi. Romi. This word means human. Romi. And the last word for our examples in letter Ro is Rakuti. Again, Rakuti. Rakuti. Rakuti, it means the castle. And was considered the name of Alexandria in our ancient history. Ancient Coptic history, especially, called Alexandria Rakuti, because the great Alexander was considering it the northern castle of Egypt, so called this place Rakuti. And after that, this place took the name of the great Alexander. Letter number 19 is Sima. Look at it. Sima. Again, Sima. And its sound is S. Not like C in English. Because C, in case of another vowel except E sound, has sound for k, for K. But in our Coptic language, Sima, the same writing for C letter, but its sound is consonant S. Okay? We will take the first example for it. Look at it. It will be Sarts. 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 And we took it in last episode. It means flesh or body. Sarts. And we always sing Abuna in liturgy of Saint Basil when praying and saying Afchi Sarks, Afchi Sarks, which means took a flesh. Another word for letter Sima, Sai. Again, Sai. Sai, it means beauty. We arrive to letter number 20, and its name is Tav. In its drawing and its sound like extremely letter T in English. Its name is Tav. Tav. And its sound is T. Let's together to try an example regarding to letter Tav. We will take an example of Tadma. Again, Tadma. Tadma. It means rank. Tadma means rank. When we say Arshi Angelus Tadma, the rank of Archangels. Another word to be an example for letter Tav, it will be Tai. Tai. Tai, and it means owner. And we always listen and see Abuna when praying, in lamb offering, when holding the lamb, he says, "Ua unem utai." Glory and honor. Uaunim utai. Utai unim uaun. Honor and glory. Last example for letter Ta is Talis. Talis. Again, Talis. Talis means a sack. As we see, Talis means a sack. Also, in our culture in Upper Egypt, till now, using the word of Talis, but not Talis, here in Upper Egypt, saying about it, Talis, for describing the sack. Talis means sack. And the last letter in our episode today is letter number 21, and its name is Epsilon. But I wanna take you in a short journey in letter Epsilon. When we see it as a whole letter, we can observe its shape like letter I or Y. But the small form in letter Epsilon, if we analyze it, we will find that it's composed of two parts. First part is O, and upper part is V. So the letter Epsilon has in our Coptic language three sounds. First sound is I or Y, and second sound is V, and third sound, as we said before, is U. I or Y, and second sound is V, third sound is U. When it comes with sound I or Y, first case of sound I, when it comes after any letter except three letters, alpha, A, Omicron. In this case, always we say it as I sound or Y sound. As we see in our example, elitos. Again, elitos. Elitos. And it means a stranger, elitos. Second case in letter epsilon is V sound. V sound when comes after two letters, alpha and A. In case of alpha, as we see our sample is Av Keen, it means neck. Av Keen. Second example we can take it today is the word of Eva. 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 Which means Eve. And we always use it in midnight praises in the hymn of Shereni Maraya. Shereni Maraya Thebilin Eva. Akthalil and Eve. It means happiness of Eve. Hail to you, Saint Mary, happiness of Eve. Eva. And also the word we took it in the beginning of this episode, the word of Epnevma. Epnevma. Here, epsilon also came after A. So, its sound is converted into V sound. Epnevma. Eva. Avkin. The third sound and the last sound. And the last sound in our episode today is the sound of U. U. And this case, just only one case, when come after Omicron. It's considered to be double U, as we say. When we analyze epsilon, especially the small shape, we will find it composed of two parts. Lower part is O and upper part is V. When comes after Omicron, its sound converted into U. We can consider it double O. When we say full, let's take a small example for it. This example of U-A-N. Again, U-A-N. U-A-N. U-A-N, it means the until now, we arrive to letter number 21 in our Coptic language. I wish to finish all our letters through next two episodes. Just I wanna your prayers a lot for all my brothers who didn't subscribe yet in our channel. You can go easily and subscribe and activate the bell of notification to get notified when we upload any new videos. For my brothers who are speaking Arabic, first generation, you can follow us in our another program in Coptic learning, but in Arabic language. It's on Tuesday. I will leave it its link below, and for the program of ritual. What should the deacon be and say? I will leave also its length below. But for Sorokin now, it's just in Arabic. If you want it in English, just tell me and I will prepare it, or prepare with Deacon Marcus. We can work together to prepare it. That's all. If you have any comment, you can leave it. I will reply it freely. If you have any message, I'm leaving my own contact information in my page. If you like our content, you can tell us and like it. If you wanna share it in your service, it will be benefit for us, for making us more easy and distribution. That's all till now. Till next time. Bye. See you.